Well, yeah, we'll need to wait there, absolutely. Thank you. Thank you. Well, it's been a really eventful week because last week I was teaching about butterflies. And in the middle of that sermon, I thought, yeah, we're going to the Pope this week. What am I going to talk about the Pope? What do I know about the Pope?
Well, I studied all week. And, oh, man.
There was so much spiritual attack on me all week. Things I had to get over. And then even at 3 in the morning, something told me, go downstairs and check over here. I turned all the gear on, and you'll see lots of pictures going up. These are all Luciferians. Every picture you see here is a Luciferian. And I'm going to prove that to you. I'm not going to be able to do it today. Today's only introduction. But 3 o'clock in the morning, none of the equipment worked. I thought, what's going on? I got the wrong computer. So I fished through the house and I found a computer that would work. Everything worked against me to shut this down. There's something that Lucifer himself doesn't want you guys to know. But we got all through that, then we're on Proctor West here, and a pole has fallen down or fell down, or the workers took it out of the pole, the electric pole. So I thought, oh man, we need the Calvary Baptist. We're going to have no power. I didn't bring a sun panel. I never brought a sun panel. And also, we prayed about that on the way here. We need it, and there's power here, and that's just great. So I'm going to title this Lucifer and his Antichrist Dose. And this is just an introduction thing. But this is the I Am Lucifer slideshow. These are Luciferians, these are Masons. You're going to see a lot of pictures of Masons here. You're going to see Seventh-day Adventists. You're going to see Roman Catholics. You're going to see Charismatics. And they're all tied together. These guys are all Luciferians. I'm going to prove to you before this study is over. And you guys are going to know it in your hearts. We're going to find who they worship. And it's not the God of Israel, Isaac, and Jacob. It is not. And we're going to see that. So the whole all the scripture today is going to be from Isaiah 14, 12 to 15. So say Isaiah 14, 12 on. And whenever I'm up here teaching or preaching, I always go to this book and I never knew why. Today I know why. I never know why too. Okay, if you want to go to, I'll just read this quickly. Isaiah 14, 12 to 15. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? Not morning star, son of the morning. Get this in your hearts. How art thou cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my...
Actually, he talks like this. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God.
That's how I believe Lucifer speaks. I will sit upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Like the Most High. Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. Can you put the video on Lucifer, please? We're going to find out who worships Lucifer, how it's all connected to the Seventh-day Adventists, all these different churches that I've been teaching on, including the Charismatics. Okay. So you notice all the Bible versions, they took out how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, and they changed it to morning star. I'm going to show you why in this Sunday video. Let's not blame that. Go back to
Right about me.
Sir, you need to be born again.
I am born again.
Did you just say that you are Lucifer?
I am Lucifer.
Okay, define Lucifer for me.
Pure, virtuous, wholesome, innocent individual that's out to help people.
Lucifer is?
Yeah.
Say that again. Lucifer is a pure, holy...
Virtuous.
Virtuous. Now, see the Lucifer that God created?
That's the same one.
Oh, man, this is great. I'm going to put this on the internet.
God bless you,
Amen.
Brother.
Because that's exactly what the Shriners and Masons teach, is that Lucifer is light.
No.
And you're
about
confirming
those hospitals?
You know what, sir? Jesus said, many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, did we not do these good deeds in your name? And you'll say, away from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you.
Jesus said
it? In Matthew chapter 5.
Mercy.
No.
That's hard to believe.
So you're a Christian and you don't know that. Actually.
No. I really am.
You are.
Because I'm pure and virtuous.
You're pure and virtuous, okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, you're perfect without Jesus, right?
No.
Okay, tell me about Jesus. Who is Jesus?
He's my leader.
Is he the Son of God?
Yes, he is.
Is he the only worshipful master?
Yes.
Have you ever been called worshipful master?
No, because I've just been too busy. I've been working.
Working?
Been working to help people.
What
like
kind
you.
Of work? Okay.
Get out of here.
See, this is what a Mason confesses is that Lucifer is light. You heard it?
Masonry, and today I'm going to show you and prove to you, if I get this video working, who they actually worship. And later in the study, I'll show you who started Freemasonry and what churches it's in. Now, today's evangelicals have swallowed the drop of poison in a bottle of water. I'll show you a bottle of water, one drop of poison, how that would corrupt your soul. Okay, going from Antichrist to Brother in Christ. I'm just going to read some statistics to you. 90% of 1,000 Protestants interviewed and asked this question. Senior pastors, including senior pastors, polled, believe that a Roman Catholic who believes this false gospel can be born again. Roman Catholics have a false gospel. They believe they can be born again. These are Baptist preachers too. They believe the Roman Catholics can be born again. Okay, now, 63% said they believe that the Pope in charge right now, who's Pope Francis, they believe that this Pope, he's a genuine Christian, a brother in Christ. These are churches in America, churches in Europe. They believe that the Pope is a genuine Christian and a brother in Christ. 58% of evangelicals believe the Pope is saved. The man's not saved. When I show you who this Pope is, he's not a false prophet. Everything you learn in school, everything you learn in Bible studies, he's not a false prophet. I'm going to show you exactly. We're going to line it up to the King James Bible, the Word of God. I'm going to show you who this Pope is. And put your seatbelts on. You're going to need it. So, we got to go to video blasphemy. Let's try that other video, because obviously that video failed for whatever reason. We'll do blasphemy. Go back and then go to blasphemy. Okay, now Pope Francis, you're going to see in this video, he's addressing the Congress. He bypasses Jesus Christ. He worships another Jesus. He's going to bypass Jesus Christ in this video. And I want you to especially watch the expressions on people's faces, especially two of the most powerful men in America, who's John Boehner and, Obama's sidekicks, his advisors. Watch the expression on the faces and listen to see if the Pope mentions anything about the gospel in his address to Congress. Because the false prophet is a religious man. This Pope is political. He's all political. And Scripture tells us what that is. Some people get there this week, but we'll get there next week. Go back to the... go back one more. Yeah, blasphemy. Click on the top on blasphemy. Amazing. Pope Francis Congress. Right back. Doesn't work? You click on it? Okay, let's open that right up. Listen very carefully. Watch the expressions on the guy's faces in the background.
Flee at the home of the brave. Pursuit of the common the chief aim of all politics. A political society endures when it seeks as a vocation to satisfy common needs by stimulating the growth of all its members, especially those in situations of greater vulnerability or risk. Legislative activity is always based
all political, it's not really the same.
Of supporting people. To this, you have been invited, called, accompanied by those who elect you. Yours is a walk which makes me reflect in two ways in the figure of Moses. Noah, the patriarch and ruler of the people of Israel, symbolizes the need of people to keep alive their sense of unity by means of just legislation. On the other, the figure of Moses leads us directly to God and thus to the transcendent dignity of the human being. Moses provides us with a good synthesis of the world. You are asked to protect by means of the rule the image of the fashioned by God on every human life.
Okay, so we saw political. I've got hundreds of hours of this guy, it's all political. He's not a, he pretends to be this religious leader, he's not the false prophet. He's not. He's something much more sinister than that.
That's only the day, but we're gonna get there.
You notice in the Catholic Church they only speak Latin. Now, Zach, the next video you're going to go to is a video, Easter Ritual, a Pope Invoking Lucifer. Okay, now they only speak Latin, but guess what? Brother Rob, maybe some other brother in here, I know Latin. I have Latin. I have got pure words in Latin. I know when this man's lying. I'm going to show you how much of a liar this man is, how much of a liar the Catholic Church tells us. I'm going to expose it all today. Just an introduction. Never mind when we get deep into it, you'll need your seatbelt. Pastor Gaines, I'll provide it for you. Put seatbelts on all these benches for next week. But watch this. Okay, can we get there, Zach? Easter Ritual, the Pope and Verse Lane invoking Lucifer.
Go back.
And we're going to see who the Catholic, the Roman Catholic Church really worship. I'm going to expose this completely to you.
Lampadis, abismo adere.
Christus filius tuus, Christus filius tuus, Christus filius tuus.
And Christ is Lucifer's son. Who is Lucifer?
Christus filius tuus, Christus filius tuus.
Come out of her, my people. Come out of her. You know what? Jesus Christ would not have said, come out of her, unless some of us are still in there. Believers are still in there. We try to warn them. They can't hear Jesus. They're under the spell. We try to warn them. We try to get up there and witness. Now, the Bible tells us to remind. Remind ourselves of things. So, Jack, let's go back. You cut that off. Go back to the video Easter vigil, Pope Francis, 2014. Let's see if he speaks any different. Pope Francis, go back one, and then you'll see Easter vigil, Pope Francis, 2014. So we're going ahead 2 years. Going ahead 2 years. Let's see what happens when Pope Francis is in charge.
Sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
Accepting all religion.
Well, it was really amazing because now I'm 31 years old and I never thought about becoming Catholic. And I'm not sure if it's going to happen, of course, but already the thought of it.
This is a Pope that struck such a huge chord among so many people in such a short time. But many do now expect him to get down to business and start tackling the very sensitive issues of reform and cleanup of the church. They hope that his humility and simplicity.
Christus filius tuus.
You're agreeing fully to it, every word. And you'll be judged for every word that comes out of your mouth. Be careful.
Inveniat ille in quam Lucifer qui nascit hoc asso. Christus filius tuus, qui regressus ab inferis, humano generis serenus illuxit, et tecum vivit et regnat in saecula saeculorum.
So that's the introduction for today. Next week, when Jersey comes. Thank you.